Alright y'all, I got my Klipsch Cornwall speakers ready to set up. Got the 8000s F back here, took out the 600s out, so it's more stable. Instead of having these speaker stands, it's much more firmer. I gotta cover the wire, so what I did too, I put my left sub over here and my right sub over here, so it's across from each other. I would think it would sound better than having them in the front, because the way the room is, it just didn't sound good at all. So I'm hoping these will change the sound of it. I got an open back here, so it's kind of hard to fill the room, but hopefully it can fill this area. So these are the Cornwalls. It's upside down, gotta flip it over, put it through, and then I'll show you that in a bit. So here's the back of the Cornwall. On the back, we have the serial number and also the person who tested it. A little information about the speaker and so forth. And then you have the speaker inputs here. These actually look pretty nice, I'm not gonna lie. This is metal, it's not plastic. And this feels like aluminum. And thankfully I got banana plugs. I'm just gonna plug them in the bottom. And these connectors will transmit to the highs. So really nice speaker. Comes with a little pamphlet. I'm gonna look at that in a bit. Here's the front. It looks really nice. This, I don't know what this is. I don't know if it's wool, if I'm correct, like wool fabric, but it looks beautiful. And it has like a glistening look to it. As you can kind of see, it's reflective, but not too much. And then here it is, 15-inch woofer front firing. So I'm gonna put this behind the acoustic transparent screen. The idea is to get three of these, I got two, and put that behind the screen. And I love the three-way, it's gonna be a lot cleaner, it's gonna look good, and I'm excited. So here it talks about the front screen, the grill, and it kind of lets you know, like, hey, if it gets a little loosened or so forth, just put it in a climate control room and it'll stabilize itself, but also it's acoustically sound, so it's very good with the sound coming through it. If you really feel it, it feels really rigid, which is kind of nice, but it's good to know too that, you know, it's gonna sound good either way. They know what they're talking about, they know what they're designing, but just so you know. So Kirsten already saw the speaker, but we wanna get her reaction of it again.
Wait, just so everyone knows, I work from home. So I'm half done right now.
Beautiful.
So just, don't judge.
What do you think of the speaker?
I think it's stuck. First of all, I hate the black. Yeah, I don't like how techy things look. That's the one thing about being married to Danny. I don't love how techy things can look. But I think this is so beautiful, and it actually looks like, how do you say, like, art is what I said. It mm-hmm. looks like artistic, and it actually
vintage,
it,
handmade.
Vintage, right? Okay. And it actually, what I like about it is, it actually looks like decor. Like, it looks very nice as opposed to techie. I like how it doesn't look so techie, because in our house, like, what tends to happen is we have
black on black.
Lots on, right.
On a nice apartment.
But my room and my office looks very different than that. Yes. So it tends to be a little mismatched, because anywhere Danny has stuff, it's very techy. So I like that it looks, you know, like decoration, and it matches the rest of my style as well.
For sure. And
I love this. I love this.
Yeah.
Like, and I love brown. I love woods. It's so pretty.
Yeah, it looks really good. The reason why I get the blacks is because it's gonna be like behind the screen or in wall eventually. Mm-hmm. Not these, but these were just good pricing. But I mean, these look amazing.
No, they look so good. I would be okay with having those in our living room.
Yeah.
Yeah, like I would be okay with having that in our living room. I think people would actually compliment it instead of just seeing like a giant black box.
All right, that's Cornwalls for the win.
Yay, we love Cornwall.